So welcome back. Here we are in round two. Apologies for a slight hiccup there on the recording. So we're here joining action halfway through the first turn. So I decided to keep his hand of two mirror, all of our colors, and revoke existence. And we're playing here against Raptor, who defeated Steve OMS in the first round. And it looks like he's going to... I mean, if you're playing this card, it's a pretty clear sign you're some kind of Metalcraft deck, because that effect isn't actually very good. So this hand, I mean, it's not great in that we actually don't have anything to do yet, right? We have these accelerators, but we don't have anything to actually accelerate into. But our deck definitely has some great options there. We draw a dragon, or we draw a battle sphere. I think we're going to be pretty happy with this hand. In the meantime, I'm going to expose the gold mirror first to the removal, as the iron mirror is more important here since it's our second source of red. So we want to protect that by giving him the shot. If he wants to kill our first mirror, take out the gold mirror. And actually, what would have actually been better would have been leading Swamp and Mountain probably into Gold Mirror to represent that this might be our only white source as well. It would be a slight improvement over the way of this, that I led the lands here. Didn't really think about it quickly enough. But I think that would have been a little better. And then in between the rounds, I was kind of replaying the draft in my head and thinking more about it. And I'm hung up on that liquid metal coating pick. I'm not sure what the right thing to do there was. As I think the coating, when you already have a Horde Smelter Dragon and a Revoke Existence, I mean, probably the right pick at that point. Because you already had two cards that, you know, definitely benefit from having it in your deck. And so I regret the taking that dual end over it, actually. Still hopefully, still waiting to draw, you know, the something to do with all this mana, but the replica should help with it. Help with that next turn. Okay, he plays his own replica. And we draw another replica, so let's go ahead and cash one of the first one in. See what comes of this. Nothing too exciting. And we'll go ahead and play out the second one. I actually think I might trade this one if he equips with his axe and attacks. Although, he gets the chance to get him next turn with the Sentinel. The issue here is this. So if we leave the replica in play, we're going to really telegraph the Sentinel in our hand. Because next turn we're going to play our 6 mana source, you know, and say go, which doesn't make sense, right? We'd activate what normally happens, you'd activate the replica to try to draw a spell to play if you didn't have one. So I think it's kind of, would be really strange to not activate. I mean, 5 damage is not insignificant here. That said, though, we don't really have any gas in our hand, so we could really easily run out of stuff to do, which is also concerning. But I think I'm going to go ahead and trade off this champion. Just don't want to take the damage and fall that far behind. And the fact that our gold mirror is not going to be attacking will actually help sell things. It would make us look like we're going to be blocking the replica with our mirror. Well, that's not what we wanted to see. I'm just going to say land go. So now he's going to have a choice. He can either... Yeah, he's at the magnet or mirror end of turn here, I think. At which point we'll flash in. Oh, he's not. Okay, so he might be attacking into it. Remains to be seen. So he's missing land drops over there, so he's a little short. And what that does, that incentivizes him to try to maximize his on-the-board mana and to put pressure on me. Especially now he has all these effects that require mana. So let's see if this replica attacks. Does not. I'm going to go ahead and flash this guy in now, actually. So we failed to get anyone, but I'm actually fine with that. And we will Vigilance on over. Maybe we'll add another mirror. And Let's throw this equipment on one of our guys. We'll put it on the legendary, I guess, here. And we'll pass the turn. Raptor finally draws his fourth land here. And you can see, I mean, his board has, you know, both the Trigon and the Dark Shellax, both are very mana intensive cards. Plus he's holding four things in his hand that we know are spells. So he's definitely bottlenecked right now in mana. And I think we want to take advantage of that by trying to get as aggressive as we can in this spot. As he tries to kind of untangle his board and get some stuff into play. Okay, Bloodshot Trainee to combo with the Darksteel Axe and the Trigon of Range. That's pretty good here. Also pretty good though is this Instill Infection, which is going to let us respond by... So let's think what we do here. First thing is we obviously attack with the Sentinel. And then I'm actually going to go ahead and remove his axe from the game, I think. And now what I can do is I can respond to him using the Trigon of Rage on the trainee by shrinking it. So, I mean, the natural play here for him is actually not even to use the Trigon because it doesn't accomplish anything, right? Turning on his trainee is not exciting this turn because he just kills a mirror. So he needs to be committing more pressure to this board, and sure enough, here is a big guy. We need to draw a spell soon, but in the meantime, we'll play another mirror. As well, send in the Sentinel. Although I can't imagine he doesn't block with the relic here. Yeah. Such an easy spot to call, right? Because I mean, my bluff is just so obvious, but need to do it because that way, if I had something, you know, it would not be obvious. So that attack just makes sense. And now let's see what he decides to get aggressive with the Tumble Magnet. If he decides to hold back. Hopefully we draw one of our Hoarder Dragons here and just lock this game up. Okay. Looks like Raptor has quite the aggressive black red deck here. Yep, didn't want to block anyway. The real question now is, do we chump the relic at this point? I mean, because the Tumble Magnet and the Trigon of Rage, you know, these combine for a lot of damage pretty quickly. So just taking this is actually pretty painful. I think we're gonna take it once. reason why I'm going to take it the one time is I want to leave this mana up. Well, I want to make sure we can play and activate our dragon in the same turn. But I guess even with one fewer mirror, we can still do that by playing this land, right? Land, dragon, activate. He has three more uses of the Tunnel Magnets. We need to get through a lot of turns. So now I'm trying to decide, does the two mana for the Trigon matter? For instance, if we let him through, is he going to pump? If we think he's going to pump, then blocking makes more sense. We save two more damage. He also has this replica. I mean, I think... Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and block, actually. I'm just a little nervous about getting that low when he has, you know, five more damage, basically. That was a good card to draw. I think we can all agree on that. Now, awkwardly, we are going to get punished for the not having that mana, which is a little ironic. Go ahead and play the land. I should have attacked my sentinel first. See if he would have tapped it down, but... Still better late than never. Sentinel still get in there. Pretty hard to see him getting through, right, with all these additional little dorks we can chump with. I imagine he's gonna, yep, start powering up the trainee, start taking down our... Oh, Trigon's plus three. That's real awkward, too. So I thought Trigon was only plus two power. So now, so I actually removed the wrong thing with the rogue existence. One of the hard spots on new sets is, you know, you start thinking you know cards before you really do. So I guess the Dark Selection should have been left in play. And we should have removed the Trigon with the Revoke Existence. Because we could then shrink the trainee so that he would not have enough power from the axe to be shooting things with this Instill Infection. And that is really unfortunate that I got that wrong. Oh, he has a lot of damage sources. That said, I mean, our battle spirit should hopefully be enough to hold the ground. Now we want to find a way to get it killed. Right now, if this thing dies, that's game. Now that we've drawn this reservoir to return it. Send in the bluff, the obvious bluff. And now what we're going to do is, I think when he uses his Trigon of Rage to activate his Blood Trap Training this turn, we're going to go ahead and kill this replica. Well, he's tapped out and can't activate. Since now that we realize we're not going to get the value that we thought we were going to out of the using on the trainee. And maybe we'll draw the Galvanic Blast and the take out the trainee too, but no, not that fortunate. So, Iron Mirror down. Okay, no taking out that one, that's fine. But if we don't draw anything, use our mana on next, and we'll probably play the Reservoir and start bringing back these mirror. It's not ideal showing him that we have the Reservoir, since it makes it less likely he'll kill off our Battle Sphere, but it's hard to kill the Battle Sphere anyway. Right, it's hard to imagine it dying in combat. Harmless little guy. Again, we really just want to draw one of our Forge Smelters, as those dragons would really end things quickly. And there, oh, sorry, Forge Smelter. Horde Smelter. Obviously, we now don't have the mana to activate it right away. So we'll go ahead and declare our attack step. Our Battle Sphere tapped. Just fine. Send in our Sentinel, just like every turn, because again, need to keep him on his toes. Though when we ever do draw something, it won't look any different. So by playing the dragon, we're going to force his hand. He's going to have to take action next turn. Just making sure it is actually the right thing to do. Because the other option, we can just play Reservoir for two, or for three rather. So six mana brings someone back. No, that doesn't work out. See if we want to play both of these this turn instead. I think better is to play both of these. Trainee down my Sun Chaser, which is fine. This forces him to have someone in his hand to deal with the dragon. And five toughness is just so much in this format. And you have the Grass of Darkness that does four, you have this trainee guy that does four. It's really hard to do five. Interesting, so you're just charging, saving it up for later. I wonder what that means. Why would he not kill our 3-3? I mean, it could be the red spell that flips over my top card and deals that much damage to everything? Nope. It's just a concession. Okay, so he's an aggressive, very aggressive black-red deck. Let's think about how we want a sideboard to handle that. Well, there's one of our deck to show up. And it's not showing up. Let me reconnect again. Having some issues today with Magic Online. So hopefully my deck will be here now. No. What is going on? Have no deck to sideboard with. Can't submit, can't do anything. See if Raptor's having the same issue. This is annoying. Let's see. So trying to remember now if Magic Online. No, it doesn't save decks, unfortunately. Try disconnecting and reconnecting one more time. Hopefully it will pop up. Thankfully it's not like a lot of changes that you want to make in this matchup, you know. Actually I'm not sure there are any, to be honest, but yeah, so it looks like we will not be getting the sideboard this game, which is too bad.